Hey guys, it's Vicky, and today I'm here to talk about my reading plans for February. I have quite the stack planned. I decided I'm not going to do my TBR jar for this month because I already have a pretty full plate for the month, especially considering it's the shortest month of the year, although we do get an extra day this year in February because of leap day. But yeah, I have big plans, so the TBR jar is out for the month. But yeah, let me go ahead and just go into what I'm going to be reading in February. So I have two books currently going that are going to carry over into the month. The first one is one that I am reading with Leia, my daughter. We got her this book for Christmas because it sounded like something she'd like. It's the start of a series, and she's loving it. Loving it. So yeah, that book is The Land of Stories by... Oh, book one is called The Wishing Spell, and it's by Chris Colfer. And this is I believe a 6-book series that deals with a set of twins, Alex and Connor, who get this book from their grandmother of fairy tales, and they quickly find out that it is magical, and you can travel into the book and go to the Land of Stories, where fairy tale characters such as Cinderella, Little Red Riding Hood, Sleeping Beauty, the Evil Queen, all of the fairy tale characters that we know and love are alive in this world. And this book, they're trying to figure out how to get back to their world. So yeah, it's really fun. We are currently on page 160, and it's like a 430-page book. It's pretty big for a kid's book, but she, like I said, she is loving it. We're taking our time. We only read about 10 pages a day, so it's taking a while. So definitely going to be reading this in February. I don't even know if we'll complete it in February. I guess we'll find out. And then the other book that I have currently going is one I just started yesterday, and that is The Terror by Dan Simmons. I'm so excited to be reading this book. It's been one that I've been wanting to read for quite a while. I've been kind of saving it for wintertime because it takes place in the Arctic. The characters are very isolated. They are stuck, literally stuck in the ice, and there's some sort of supernatural, creepy thing that's attacking them. So yeah, I'm enjoying it so far. I'm only 30 pages in, so I have a lot of book to go, but I'm enjoying it already, and I will definitely be finishing it in February. All right, so the rest of my books are just kind of random books that I wanted to read this month. The first one is a buddy read that I'm going to be doing with Bobbi over at Bobbi Reads Too Much, and that is A Ladder to the Sky by John Boyne. We buddy read The Heart's Invisible Furies last year and both absolutely loved it. It's a new favorite for both of us, so we were really excited to read another John Boyne book. This is his newest one that came out last year, and it deals with a writer who is trying to, I believe he's trying to steal the work or the ideas of another writer. So you have this this protagonist who is very unlikable, and it just sounds like an interesting story. Like I said, we both loved John Boyne's writing in The Heart's Invisible Furies, so we are super excited to dive into this one. So as you guys know, I've said this before, in the wintertime, I tend to gravitate more towards historical fiction. That's probably when I read it the most, is in the wintertime. And this is an author that I'm trying to work my way through her stuff, and I figured it was a good time to pick up one of her books. That is The House at Riverton by Kate Morton. This will be my third Kate Morton book. I have read The Secret Keeper and The Clockmaker's Daughter. This one deals with a young girl that lives in an estate where I believe her mother is a maid, or maybe she's a maid. I can't remember now. But the summer of 1924, there's this awesome party going on at the estate, and this poet commits suicide. And then it kind of, in typical Kate Morton fashion, there's like a present day story that is tied to that story in the past, and some sort of mystery trying to be figured out. And then I've heard this one too has kind of an upstairs downstairs kind of feel, like Downton Abbey type feel, where you have like the help and the people that live there and how they interact and all that. So I'm excited for this one. I think it's going to be good. Kate Morton's books are always enjoyable, though they do take a little longer to get through. They're kind of slow burns, but they're usually worth it. My next February read is my book of the month pick for January. It's a mystery thriller that I'm super excited about. It's kind of buzzy right now, and that is The Sundown Motel by Simone St. James. I read The Broken Girls by Simone St. James 2 years ago and really enjoyed it. It was super atmospheric, super creepy, like way more creepy than I was expecting like a thriller to be. And this one seems like it's gonna kind of be the same way. It's got two timelines. There's a timeline that's going on in the 80s and a timeline going on in the present day. And it centers around this motel that is maybe haunted, has some sort of supernatural stuff going on. The present day story is a girl is wondering what happened to her aunt who disappeared in the motel back in the 80s, and her aunt worked there. So there's kind of that whole dual timeline thing happening. And like I said, if it's anything like the Broken Girls, there's definitely going to be some like atmospheric creepy stuff in here and on top of like the mystery. So I'm really, really excited about this one. My next February read is one that I've been putting off for winter time because it takes place in the winter and deals with people being snowed in at a place. So I thought I gotta read it in the winter time. And that book is Bellwether Rhapsody by Kate Reculia. And it takes place in a hotel where this band, like an like a marching band or like a some sort of like orchestra band, high school band, is there. They're staying there because they have some sort of competition that they're doing, going to, and they get snowed in. And there's also this sort of mystery of years prior, there was a murder-suicide that happened in a particular room at the hotel that people say is haunted. And while the band is there snowed in, one of the members goes missing. So it's like, okay, is there a ghost or something that's wreaking havoc? What happened to this girl? And like I said, the whole atmosphere of like being snowed in at this time of year just sounds super appealing to me. And then my last potential read for February, I don't know if I really want to read this, but as some of you may know, Kayla over at Books and Lala has started her own book club, The Literally Dead Book Club, I believe it's called. And the first book is going to be read in February, and the choice was The Other People by C.J. Tudor. And I'm a little on the fence about this because I read The Chalk Man last year and I didn't like it. It was a two-star read for me. So I'm not sure if I want to give C.J. Tudor another chance. I think I might. This might be a good time to give her another chance. I don't know. The thing is, I don't want to purchase this book. I want to try to get it from the library in case I don't like it. And my library doesn't have it as of right now. I looked online today and they don't have it where you can put it on hold yet. So I don't know if they're going to get it. So it's a maybe for me because I'm definitely not going to buy the book. But it deals with a guy who 3 years prior to the start of the story, his daughter went missing. She disappeared in the back of a car. He literally watched her disappear. And he's been searching for her ever since, driving up and down that highway where he saw her last. And obviously he's very upset about it and obsessed about finding her. Many people around him think that he may have had something to do with it. So there's that. Then there's like two other timelines where there's one with a girl who's like I think she's a waitress at like a diner on the highway whose father was murdered years ago. So she kind of feels bad for this guy who's like searching for his daughter, even though everyone thinks that she's dead. And then there's this other story with a mother-daughter pair that are on the run, and they're kind of on that same highway. So I feel like it all is going to somehow come together, these three stories, and it all has to do with this stretch of road. I don't know. I don't know. Is it aliens? Is it a supernatural force? Is it, I don't know. I have no idea. So yeah, like I said, I'm not sure if I'm going to read it because if I can't get my hands on a copy without having to buy it, I'm not going to read it. But I will let you guys know if I do end up reading it, what I thought about it. All right, guys. So those are my reading plans for the month of February. Please let me know down below what you're planning to read in February. Let me know if you're planning to join in on Books and Lala's book club. Cause I think it's going to be fun. The plan is that she's always going to have a mystery thriller horror book every month to read. So that sounds like a great time. It's just this first pick. I'm not sure if I'm on board yet. So yeah, let me know down below if you're going to take part in that. And let me know what you're reading because I would love to know. Other than that, I hope you guys are having a great week. I hope that February treats you well, and I'll chat with you very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.